A very good evening to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. This is Rajiv and in this tutorial we will talk about some basic typing skill in Word 2019. However, typing is not a big deal. Everybody knows how to use keyboards, but still I will insist you to watch this video till the end to know more about basic typing skills using Word 2019. So as we have this file, I have typed this already. And I will retype this document later on. Let me show you a few things first before we dig into the typing skills. So first of all, as we have this document, from the home tab, if you click paragraph mark button, show hide paragraph mark, then you will start seeing all these symbols on your document. These different symbols define different things. And to know about these symbols, first let's go to the view tab and here click on the word count. And when you click on word count, then you get this screen where it shows you different stats. So first of all, it is showing you that you have how many pages you have in this document, that is 1, and how many words you have typed in this document, that is 102. And how many characters you have in this document is 486 without spaces. And if you include spaces in this document, then it becomes 585. That is 99 spaces between all these words. And then you have 11 paragraphs and 16 lines. So you have to note down these last two stats, paragraph and lines. It is showing you that you have written 11 paragraphs and 16 lines. Whereas if you see carefully, then most of us only consider a paragraph like this, as you can see here from this point onwards. We mostly count these kind of lines as a paragraph. And most probably you will notice that you only have 2 paragraphs in this document and rest of the contents are separate lines, that is showing 16 lines. But that is not the case in Word 2019. Or even in earlier versions. As it is showing you 11 paragraphs, so let's count the paragraph first. So in Microsoft Word, when you hit the enter key after writing some contents, then it will always count this line as a single paragraph. So when you press an enter key, then this mark is called the paragraph marks, which means you are starting a next paragraph. And if we count all these paragraph marks, let first we count them, that is the first one, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11, 12 and 13. And if we go to the word count, then here it is showing 11 paragraphs. So where are rest of the two? During the word count, Microsoft Word don't count those paragraph marks which are empty, where not a single character has been written. Let's say if I type a full stop here and again I go to word count, then you can see that it is now showing 12 paragraphs. So that is how Microsoft Word count a line as a paragraph when you hit the enter key in the end of a line. And if you count the lines, then they will be 16, like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16 lines. So these were the important points you have to know, that whenever you will press the enter key, Microsoft Word will count that line as a separate paragraph and will ignore empty line as a paragraph. And each line will be counted as a single line. Like here we have 4 different lines in a single paragraph. If I select this paragraph and again go to review tab and click word count, then you can see that it is showing you that it is a single paragraph having 4 lines. Now if I click on the spelling and grammar under the review tab, then it will say you that all the spelling and grammar are completely fine in this document, and hit the OK key. But if you go to the file options and here in under proofing, you can make a check mark on show readability statistics and hit the OK key. Now if you will click the spelling and grammar check, after completing the spelling and grammar you will see readability statistics and you will get more detail about your document, like how many words you have, how many characters, paragraphs, sentences, and moreover, you will also get the average detail about your each paragraph, sentence, and word, like how many sentences each paragraph contain, and how many words each sentence contain, and how many characters each word contain. So that is how you can check that how many paragraph and lines you have written in a document. Now if we move again to file option, and here under display, you can see always show these formatting marks on the screen, and below you can see show all formatting marks is already checked and object anchor is checked. Object anchor is checked by default in Microsoft Word 2019. But this option show all formatting marks is not checked by default. It is now checked because you have turned on show hide paragraph marks. If you turn off the show hide paragraph mark button right from here and again go to file option display, then you will see that that option is unchecked now. And if I make a check mark right here and hit the OK key, then you can see that this show hide paragraph mark button will automatically get pressed. So you can either show or hide paragraph marks from this button, or you can make a check mark under the display right here. Or if you only want to see particular paragraph marks, let's say I only want to see spaces and paragraph marks inside my document, then you can make a check mark on both of these options and hit the OK key. Now you will only see paragraph mark and the spaces between the words like this. So when you apply paragraph marks from the file option display settings, then it doesn't matter either this button is on or off, it will always start showing you these paragraph marks which you have checked from the file option display settings. So I am gonna uncheck them all and hit the OK key. Now we will type this letter again, and I will tell you some basic thing you need to consider when you are typing inside a Word document. So here I am going to open a new file, file new blank document, and I will move that file to the second screen I have. So I will start typing right from here, and we will start with 2. And if you want to add a space between two words, like here on in the left side I have written 2 and in the right side I want to write date, to add space most of the user use space key to add multiple spaces between words, like after writing 2 to write date right here at this point, I have added so many spaces to have this much of blank space between both of these words. But that is the not right way. If you turn on show hide, then you can see that I have pressed so many spaces to have this much of blank space between these two words. And if I go to review word count, then you can see that I have added 122 spaces, that a lot of much of spaces. And that is not the right way. If you want to add space between two words within a single line, then instead of pressing space keys, you can use the tab key from the keyboard. And when you press the tab key, it leaves half inch by default. So as many times you will press the tab key, it will start adding half an inch space between the words. So here at 4.5 inch, right here you can see at the ruler I am standing right below the 4.5 inch. And if you are not seeing the ruler, you can turn it on by going to the view tab, and then you can make a check mark on the ruler. And here now I can write the date. Now I am going to hit the enter key, and here you have the second paragraph and second line begin. And here I am going to write the name, the designation, company name, address, so now I am going to write a paragraph here. So here is some important things that you need to consider while writing a paragraph. So let me type it first. And here I am again going to write the date 50th June 2019. And as soon as I will press space after writing 15th, you can see that it has shrunk the th and superscripted it on the top of the 15 automatically. And how it does that, and to show you that, go to the file, option, proofing, and autocorrect options. And here under the auto format, as you type, you can see that, and here you can see ordinals, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, like this, with superscript. That means it will change the ordinals to the superscript. And what is that superscript is, let me show you. Let's say I have written first here, and I want ST to be superscripted on top of the first. So however, Word 2019 or even earlier version can do that automatically because of that option I have shown you recently. But if you want to do it by yourself, what you can do, you can select that ST, go to the home tab, and here you can find that command under the font section, superscript. And if you click this button, then it will superscript that both characters and will move them on the top of first. So that is what that superscript means. Let me write the rest of the paragraph. As you can see that our page is going to end here at 6.5 inch right here. That means if I am going to write another word here, it will not get fit in the same line and will move down automatically. But most of the users I have seen that they notice that the page is going to end and they hit the enter key to start the next line, and that is totally a wrong way to write a paragraph inside Word 2019 or earlier versions. When you hit the enter key, then Word thinks that you have started a new paragraph, and there will be a lot of confusion if you add enter in end of each line inside a paragraph. And what will be that? Let me show you. Now I am going to write the next line, which is starting have been a. So as soon as I have typed been and hit the space key, it automatically capitalized the first letter of the been. And why it did so? Because it is assuming that this is the next paragraph, and this next paragraph, the first letter of the each word of a new paragraph or new line will automatically get capitalized. And why Microsoft does that? To see this, you can again go to the file options, and here under proofing, go to the autocorrect options, and here you can find under autocorrect tab, capitalize first letter of sentences. That option is checked by default. Capitalize first letter of sentences. That means whenever a new sentence will start or a new paragraph will begin, then it will automatically capitalize the first letter. That is why it is capitalizing the B of being, because it is assuming that it is the next line. So keep in mind that you don't need to press the enter key while typing a paragraph inside Word documents. You just continue to type and it will automatically wrap the text to the second line. As you can see that again the page is going to end, and I have further more words to write. So I will not do anything and will continue to write the words, and Microsoft Word will automatically wrap those words to the next line. So as this paragraph is end now, and I want to begin the next paragraph, so now I will hit the enter key to start a new paragraph. And again I am going to hit enter to start the next line, and finally I am going to end the letter right here. So if we go to review and click the word count, you can see how many lines, paragraph, words you have written in this document. So that is the correct way of typing inside a Word document. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. In our next tutorial, we will do a basic formatting of this letter and will try to improve the style of this document using the basic formatting commands from the Home tab, including these font commands and the paragraph setting commands that I will describe you in my next tutorial. Till then, have a good time and take care.